Yes, here it is. Stream Deck profile for BBCSO Spitfire hybrid template, and I'm about to show you how it works. Hi and welcome to another video. My name is Euan Smith and welcome to Euan Smith Music. If this is your first time here, then please don't forget to like and subscribe to this video. I'm going to be doing a lot of tutorials similar to this and also to help you make your music masterpiece. All the links that I'll mention will be included in the description below for my socials, but also more importantly, the templates that I'll be sharing with you in this video. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can use the Elgato Stream Deck to control Logic Studio and in particular the hybrid template provided by Spitfire Audio for the BBC Symphony Orchestra. We're going to show you what the template looks like and some of the features and extended features that are available for you to use. My plan is to make the version for the standard size Stream Deck, but I'm also going to be working on an XL version as well. And once that's finished, I'll also include that in the description below. So here we are in Logic Studio, and I've just dimmed the screen ever so slightly just to show you and focus more on the Stream Deck. So as you can see, this is the home screen, which you can see has got a rather attractive picture was provided by Spitfire Audio, and I've just use this as the home page for the template itself. If you tap on the Spitfire Audio logo, it brings you into a very attractive screen here, which you can see, and it's really, really handy because it allows you to open up Logic Studio and it allows you to open up the Spitfire Audio app should you require it as well, and any files, especially at the moment if there's any updates that you need to do to any sound libraries that you're using. Handy to be able to do that within one keypress rather than going away from the application itself. Going over to the top right, you've got hotkeys, and then of course you've got various quick commands which I have put on the main page, which for the hybrid template include different sections of music like pre-roll, count and cue, show hidden tracks, and of course the stacks, because the stacks are organized. So moving on from there then, you've also got the ability to record, to stop, to start, to go back to the beginning, and also to open up the loops, as well as cycle a particular section. So these are particularly quick options for you to go into, but the more exciting part is if we tap on hotkeys, I've kind of customized these logos with different titles inside, and as you'll see, we'll quickly go into each one. You've got your standard undo, cut, copy and paste, which is very handy to have. You can of course drag this around to make this more convenient for yourself, and if you have Stream Deck XL, then you can of course have both of these commands on both pages on one sheet as well. Going from the second row, we've got duplicate track, which basically allows you to duplicate the current track that you have selected, so it just saves you having to command in D, which is quite handy. And then we go into the more deep dive type controls. You can see I've titled some of these already. You've got different opportunities to be able to quickly navigate around as you're recording, as you are experimenting. And what I've also been able to do is capture recording. So if you've been busking an idea and you think, I really want to keep that idea, then just tapping capture recording, you'll be able to keep that idea and it will import it into your project. So things like that are really, really useful. Going back then, let's go into locators controls. I've got different versions of the locators controls, which allow you to set different locators left and right, allow you to shuffle the locators, to delete things inside a locator or delete things outside a locator. These are quick commands that have been used with multiple key presses, but you only need to tap the Stream Deck one. So these are good kind of power user commands for you to use. So I'll go into some of those in more detail, and of course you'll be able to see on Logic what that does. Tools, quite straightforwardly, you've got various tools which you can then change, you can cycle through different ones. Channel controls, you can skip up and down tracks, you can mute certain auxiliary tracks, you can unmute them as well. So again, lots of hot keys and multiple key presses within the one key press, which is very useful. You've also got the folders, which have asterisks. So what you can do is you can select MIDI plugins, and you can also select audio plugins. You can cycle those through from 1 to 14. Again, these are advanced key press options, which are available in Logic, but don't have a key press assigned to them. So these are really useful. You've also got solo and then record arm and various other options here, as well as options to copy and paste, cut different kind of channel settings. You've also got a copy and paste plugin settings, and you've got a chance to be able to copy and paste other settings as well based on the channels. What I've also done is I've exported this as a Stream Deck profile. I've also exported the Logic Studio keypress map, which has the standard Logic Pro X keypresses for version 10.4.2, but also has these additional keypresses in there as well. So there'll be nothing that should overwrite your existing ones. Standard keypresses for all of Logic will still be the same, but obviously included added are the extra key presses as well. And we can go finally into miscellaneous again, things like, do you want a count in, do you want a metronome, things like that. You can display different things such as the keyboard input, and if you go into screen set, you can also change which screen set you're viewing. So if you want main view, mixer view, etc., you can change that, and these all tally up with the views that you will use on the actual program. That is a very, very, very quick overview of the environment which I have created. We've also got other ones as well, including navigation. These allow you to change the locator position, change also the region position. So if you've got a block of regions you want to move back or move forward, one single key press will do that for you. You've also got zoom options as well, which allow you to be able to zoom in different windows as well, which is very handy instead of having to go all the way up to the top right hand side of the screen. This one key press will help you as well. You can also got different track commands as well. So changing different automations from read, write, latch, etc. These have all been tested, these all work, and these are all very useful as a quick way of going in there rather than using the keyboard shortcut. And of course the navigation, you can go into a deep dive of those. So let's have a look at how this looks like in Logic. So here we are in the Logic template, and of course you can see you've got all the stacks on the left hand side from the hybrid template. This is available from the video, which I'll also link below in the description as well. You can download this hybrid stack from Spitfire Audio, and we'll go and cycle through very quickly. So from the previous Stream Deck command, you can also see that you can actually cycle through all the different sections. You can go to pre-roll, you can go to count, you can go to the queue. You can customize these within the actual Stream Deck as well. There are other commands later on, which if you wanted to go to a different section, you could actually do that through the hotkeys by navigation. So you can go to the hotkeys and then the navigation, and then you can go into more, and then you'll be able to select using the punch sort of buttons. You can skip forward and back like that, or you can go backwards and forwards within different measures as well. So once you've skipped around, you can also show and hide hidden tracks just by one key press, and you can also open the stacks as well, which is again something which is to avoid you having to use too many mouse movements. So again, that's just one way to try and make your workflow a little bit easier, a little bit quicker. So imagine you recorded, let me just put in an empty region. So if you were to go into the controls, you could actually stop and play from the beginning, play from the left locator, play from the right locator, which is at the end. You can play from the previous bar again, go back to your selection and play from that selection, play from the left edge of the screen, go to the playhead, which obviously need to be able to do once you've stopped, and then go to the left locator. Auto punch is quite handy, again it's really handy to do on the fly. It's really handy to have this red screen open to be able to see all these different commands. Cycle on and off, fairly self-explanatory. Record toggle, you can of course record as you're playing or off, etc. And then of course you can record repeat too, and you can repeat as much as you want. And of course anything you've played on your keyboard, as I said before, the capture recording is a very useful thing. Locators wise, you can set the left locator and you can then change that, and then you can put that in with a particular command. You can also set the right locator again. These are just really useful shortcuts to be able to do if you're not sure of what the key commands are. There's a lot of key commands that involve function keys and full-size keyboards. A lot of these are in one single key press, and it's quite handy. You can also set your locator to a marker and then cycle. You can actually shift your locator by marker, so if you wanted to just cycle through those markers, obviously we've only got three markers, that's worthwhile doing. Or you can just go through every single section here like this, and you can also jump forward and jump back quite easy. Hold down the key, hold it down too far, you get a little error, but that's not the problem. Tools just in the top, which is quite handy. You can then obviously cut things if you wanted. Again, there's always more options for you to do so. Undo that at a flick of a switch. Now I've tried to include the undo button in most of these pages. Not all the pages have them, but I mean, it's just one key press and then undo, or if you want, Command and Z. But I'm sure you'll all have your own workflow, and as I say, if you're just new to Logic Studio, it's quite a good way of unearthing some new commands as well. Going over to the editing features, it's quite nice with this one in that basically the editing features allow you to shuffle the region from left to right if you wanted to do that. You can also move all the regions if you wished to. Zoom, fairly self-explanatory. You can zoom or shrink the size of the project by using the key commands within the zoom section. You can also do the same vertically and such like. Obviously, if you know key commands on the keyboard, that's useful, but again, they're just useful for you to be able to have that. And also you can quick zoom, quick shrink as well. Same with the vertical too. In terms of the track controls, you can obviously change the read and then touch and then latch and then show and hide your automation. So basically that's all in there. So just record, enable or disable just by clicking R on your keyboard, or record on the actual Stream Deck. So again, it's a combination of being quick and such like. I use a Stream Deck to be able to allow me to use different streaming software to change between different angles and sources. Then I discovered the app Switcher Studio on iOS, which is what you use multiple iOS devices to give you a multiple camera view, and also screen share as well, which is how I'm able to show the Mac too. The more I've used Logic Pro X, the more I have discovered the need for necessitating complicated key commands with just one press. Logic Studio can be used with a Stream Deck, which is very handy. I see a lot of people using them as part of their studio, and I'm hoping that this template will help you to help make your music masterpiece more efficiently using Logic Studio. There are many, many more templates out there, not just for Logic, but also for Pro Tools and for many others. So a quick Google search and you'll find that there'll be many people who have devised their own. And of course, if you've got any that you would like to share or link to, please drop a comment below with yours. And if you want to indeed suggest something much, much better in terms of this particular template, this particular Stream Deck profile, then please do suggest that and share that as well. I would like to give a massive thank you to my Patreons. My Patreons, of course, have helped me to support, make videos, and also to help write and fund my music making as well. If you would like to become a VIP family member, then please head over to patreon.com/euansmith and help me as well on my journey. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.
The video on the top is one that I think you will love, and the one on the bottom is one that YouTube thinks you will enjoy. If you would like to know more about how to make your music masterpiece, then don't forget to click like and subscribe. See you in the next video next week. Bye bye.